Hello and welcome to Kitchen Stories. Today in Kitchen Stories, we'll be making a very easy and yummy dessert called Mango Delight. So let's see what all we need to make this dessert. To make Mango Delight, we'll be needing gelatin. This is 3 teaspoons of gelatin. Then we'll be needing sugar. This is 6 tablespoons of sugar. We'll be needing Fruity, 160 ml. So I have taken 2 packs of Fruity. Then I'll be needing a few yellow color. It's optional. Beater obviously to beat my cream. 1 big chopped mango. This is for decoration. 200. This is milk fresh cream, 200 ml. You can even take Amul fresh cream. And then I'll be taking 1/2 cup of water for my gelatin. So come, we'll make Mango Delight. So now to first make Mango Delight. In this small pan, I'll just be adding this 1/2 cup of water, and till the time this water gets heated up, in this another pan, I'll be adding my Fruity. So what are we going to do? We have to take 2 separate pans, and then we have to first dissolve the gelatin. In another pan, we'll be adding this Fruity juice. So I'll be adding both the Tetra packs. Now I'll be taking another Tetra pack. So this will account for almost 400 ml of Fruity. So you can see I've put it. Now by this my water has also come to a boil. So I'll just be adding my gelatin. Slowly add your gelatin and mix it well so that it dissolves properly in this water. Make sure the water is just lukewarm, it should not boil. So I switched off my gas and I'm just mixing the gelatin in my water. So you can see how well it has been mixed. So it should dissolve like this properly. Once it's dissolved, now I'll be switching on my gas with the Fruity. So when you're even heating the Fruity, make sure even this is lukewarm. So now slowly I'll be adding the sugar to this. So to add, why do we put it on gas is so that this sugar dissolves in the Fruity. You can even take powdered sugar. So like this, I've added all my sugar to it. And I don't want it to come to a boil. I just want the sugar to melt properly. So on a high flame, I'll just be dissolving my sugar really well. If you take powdered sugar, it will get dissolved much easier. Make sure your Fruity doesn't boil. It just has to get a little warm. And then the sugar will automatically melt to it because you're continuously stirring it. Now you can see all my sugar has melted in this Fruity. So now I'll be adding this gelatin mixture slowly to my Fruity mixture. Gelatin basically will help you to set your dessert. And make sure at this time your gas is switched off. You have to keep mixing it while you're adding the gelatin mixture. Now I'll be adding the rest of the mixture and I'll just mix it well. Now you have seen it has gotten little thickened. So now I'll just be putting it in a Borosil dish and I'll just put it for 10 minutes in the fridge to chill. So here I'm putting this in my Borosil dish. You can see it's become one mixture. So that's how it should be. And now I'll just put it in the fridge for 10 minutes to chill. Now I've put that fruity mixture in the freezer for 5 minutes, and if you put it in the fridge, you have to put it for 10 minutes. It should just be chilled, it should not be thick. So that's why. Now I'll be taking this fresh cream and I have to beat it really nicely. So this is 200 ml of fresh cream, so I'll be kneading the whole. And when you beat cream, you have to beat it really on slow, on like on one reading. You don't have to beat it on three reading, because if you beat it more, it will turn into butter. So that thing also you have to be careful with. Now I'll be using the beater to beat my cream. You can even use hand mixer. Like this, slowly you have to just beat your cream. You can even beat it with hand. With hand it will just take a little more time. So always tilt your dish and beat it when you're beating it with a beater. And make sure your cream is very cold when you're beating it. Yeah. So now my cream is done. You don't have to beat it much. So yeah. So I'll be adding little color to it and beating it a little more. The color is optional. If you want to add it, you can. Yeah. Now I've taken it out of the freezer, so I'll just once mix it with my beater. I've not switched on my beater. It should just be cold enough. Now I'll take it out in another container because I have to beat this fruity mixture. So I'll just be pouring it in this round bowl. And now I'll be switching on my beater, and at slow speed I'll be. Now I'll slowly incorporate my cream in this. And I'll again beat it. Adding another set of cream. So you can add your cream in 2 to 3 batches as your convenient beating. Again beat it. So you can see how frothy it has become. That's how it should be. Now that I have beaten it well, I'll be adding it to my another container so that I can put it in the fridge for 3-4 hours. so that it sets well. So just add it to your container and then put it in the fridge for 3-4 hours till the time it sets. And once it sets, then I'll be adding these chopped mangoes for decoration. So you have to add it only after this has set. So now let's go and keep it in the fridge. Now that we have taken it out of the fridge after 3-4 hours, you can see how beautifully it has been set. This is the way it should set. So now I'll be taking these mangoes and decorating it. As I had already told you that after it sets, you have to decorate it with mangoes. So I'll beautifully decorate it with the mangoes. So now our yummy mango delight is ready to eat. So enjoy it and please like, share and subscribe to Kitchen Stories.